against the former male model Liam Nolan out of the UK, with Knowles in his corner. Training partner, of course, a former ONE Super Series world champion, the General Jonathan Haggerty.
Yeah, Liam Nolan has a very similar style to Jonathan Haggerty. Like that push kick, they set it up the same way. A lot of feints come off of that push kick, and they like to close that distance as well.
On ONE Fantasy, on the ONE Super app, the world's largest martial arts fantasy game, 57% of fans are tipping Brown for a win over Liam Nolan tonight. Good round kick upstairs from Nolan. Brown goes downstairs. Looks to the inside leg is Brown. Both men very sharp on the release of their kicks and their elbows. Brown kick there, trying to loop the shin around the back of the neck. Good jab, high kick from Nolan. Forcing Brown against the rope. Brown ties him up. The owner is going to break them. Solid start, no real thinning out process in this one. Set for three rounds. Three judges ringside scoring on a 10-point must system. Harvard's round again from Nolan. Jumping roundhouse kick from Nolan. And that southpaw stance. Orthodox stance for Brown.
Nolan's really starting to come into his own. We saw an excellent performance at when he competed against Bong Pinoy last time we saw Liam Nolan. He lost a little bit of a majority decision because he wasn't as active as he wanted to be. He believes he's made the necessary adjustments to correct that here tonight.
Rear leg so far working a treat for Liam Nolan. Inside leg kick nicely done there for the young man from London. So let's start here from Nolan. Cracks away that left leg again. Rounds record 26-10-1. Two-time Raw being kickboxing champion. 16-6-1 for the Raw Combat League world champion, Liam Nolan.
Nolan's been very active inside that close range. As soon as Brown Pinot steps into that range, he immediately starts firing those elbows.
Nolan gloves up high, looking through his brow. Left round kick there. Back leg of the southpaw. Gives up the experience to Brown, but wouldn't go again. This is a formidable start from Liam Nolan. Catch it, counter, nicely done. From Nolan.
Nice combination thrown off the release there. Liam Nolan's really starting to find his range. He's starting to put a lot of aggression into a lot of these combinations. Brown's going to have to solve this puzzle real quick.
Lots of instructions from Nolsey out of Nolsey Academy in the corner of Liam Nolan. Final 10 seconds of the opening round. Once again, folks, give the more dominant athlete 9 points on your personal scorecard. The less dominant athlete should get 9, the more dominant should get 10. There's the end of the first round. We go to the towel.
Very active round coming off of Liam Nolan. Look at this. Beautifully done. Just disrupts the balance just a little bit there. Just kind of, you can see Brown caught it at the edge of there, his forearms, but a lot of forward pressure coming from Liam Nolan. And that's what he needed to do. He needed to get off to a very quick start. Typically, you see a lot of these Muay Thai athletes have a slower first round, but that's the difference between ONE Super Series. You're only allowed 3 rounds, so you don't have that time to get used to that first round. So you immediately have to jump on your guys. And if you can walk away with a quick round under your belt, it really gives you confidence moving into the second and third stanza, Michael.
Wherever you're watching around the world, folks, how do you score us? Let us know across all your social media platforms, at ONE Championship on Twitter, YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram. Do you have a 10-9 for Liam Nolan? Do you have a 10-9 for Brown? Referee Ulnari gets us underway. Second of three. Four-ounce gloves, ONE Super Series Muay Thai. Knees, elbows, all the good stuff. Probing jabs here from Nolan, trying to back Brown up. Good cracking rear leg round kick again. And once more, both trying to damage the upper right ribs and also chop down the forearm of Brown, so he'll drop that forearm and maybe allow Nolan to kick him flush in the head. Nolan's got speed and precision. High kick there from Nolan again, relying on that back leg, being the power side of the southpaw.
Nice long guard coming from Liam Nolan. You can see Brown's having a little bit of a hard time trying to cut through that guard.
Brown has been very confident, very quiet around the hotel all week with his entourage, sightseeing around Singapore, making weight quite well. Came in highly prepared for this one. Nolan as well. Having spoken to him and his trainer, Nolsey, very calm confidence in the young man. Like red welts you see on the biceps there of Nolan, where he's caught those round kicks off the left leg of Brown. Roundhouse kick off the back leg there from Nolan. Doubles up and a Brown double forearms guard. Arms turned forward, open fingers on both men here. Initial Thai stance will have the arms face outwards for a few reasons. One of them to catch the jabs coming in and to also be able to parry those punches and also evade those elbows, go against those elbows. You'll see plenty of elbows, I'm sure, in our main event, Nongo versus Senapet Fairtex for the Bantamweight World Championship. Both men in that main event have promised to knock out with the elbows. Probing jab from Liam Nolan. Switch up. Round kick to the head there from Nolan. Thought about a jumping knee, did Brown. See the Sakyant tattoos on the back there of Brown. These tattoos are traditionally done with the needle and the little hammer. Painful process. As long with a monk's blessing, usually. A protective blessing for the athlete. One kick there from Nolan. We know that's one of the specialties of Nolsey's academy. See it often from the general, Jonathan Haggerty. Putting back elbow jab.
30 seconds left.
Brown. Good idea from Brown to try and go the 45 degree trajectory on the elbow. There's a downward elbow off the back arm from Brown. It's a front kick. Get around here from Brown. Slapping punch off the left hand, four box punch combination, spinning elbow there from Brown, jumping around kick, nicely done, Brown appreciated it, from Liam Nolan.
Nice little elbow there, as you can see, Brown tried to close that distance with the spinning elbow, Liam Nolan saw it coming, because this is like the second time he threw it that round, he was able to drop one in his own.
We are broadcast to over 140 countries around the world tonight. Make sure you check your local TV guide. Here in Singapore on Toggle and Channel 5, BR Live and TNT on the USA. Big hello to all of our fans on Star Sports Select 2 and Hotstar in India. How about those guys in Myanmar? They love us on Skynet and MNTV. How do you have it, folks? You have it two rounds to zip in favor of Nolan. That would make it 2018 to Nolan. You have it one round apiece. Maybe 10-9 Nolan first, maybe 10-9 Brown second. One more round to go, and still, I dare say, anyone's for the taking. Third and final as a great crowd builds into the Singapore Indoor Stadium. We are expecting a sellout. The hottest ticket in Singapore tonight is One Championship Edge of Greatness.
Go!
Mitch, what does Brown need to do for the next 3 minutes?
I like how he turned up the volume there in that second round. He needs more of that. I like how he's subtly stepping off to the left. You can see that that front leg is very important. Whoever controls that left foot, whoever controls that center step, is going to be able to control that right hand, or the left hand in Liam Nolan's case. So it's going to be very important. I'd like to see him maybe step off that center line a little bit, throw that right hand a lot more.
Right hand lead there from Brown out of orthodox stance. Nolan's left glove up very high to defend against that right round kick. Checks the low kick, does the man from Great Britain. Right hand lead again from Brown. Anyone's for the taking here, but who wants to dig a little deeper in the third and final round of really steal the show? Good right hand there from Brown. Throwing that right without a setup for most of this round so far. But a good rivalry over the years between Dutch Muay Thai stylists as opposed to England and the rest of the UK. Hooking punch there from Brown.
Brown is dangerous inside that boxing range. He has to go those combinations. I like to see him throw a little bit more. Especially ending it with the punt, the kicks as well. He's doing a good job of piecing up that inside leg of Liam Nolan. But Liam Nolan's got to be a little bit more active this time. He's got a minute and a half to do as much work as he can. And right now, it looks like Brown's figured out the range. He also figured out the distance as well.
Nolan had a tremendous opening round. May have gone off the pace a little in the second. And it's Brown who's landing the better punches here in the third round. Good front kick there from Nolan. Cracking round kick, that's more like it from Liam Nolan. Damaging those upper right ribs of the Dutchman Brown. Spinning back elbow from Brown. Nolan tried to make it pay. Brown pulling Nolan forward. 100 minutes to go, third and final. So when it went to the tanking, would have very well been one round apiece after two. There are no draws in one Super Series. Punch combination, full court for Brown. Also the left hand out of southpaw stance for Nolan. Good round kick.
To a 30 seconds left Brown. In the final round.
You can see as this match is wearing on, you can see Brown's made the necessary adjustments inside the range, finding exactly where exactly Nolan is going to retaliate back. And he's just slightly out of the range when Nolan fires back.
Final seconds, front kick from Nolan. 3-2 combination from Brown. Got Nolan against the ropes here. Hooking, catch and counter there from Brown. There it is, we got another judges in this featherweight contest. How do you score it, folks? Do you have it for Brown? Do you have it for Liam Nolan after three?
You can see Brown was just trying to figure out that distance. You could see that Nolan liked that push kick, but once Brown kind of figured that out, he was able to start to let those hands go. Good work on Liam Nolan's side just to keep active with that push kick. I liked how he was touching him up with the inside leg kicks, but you could see that as the match wore on, Brown's experience just kind of came to fruition, and you were able to see the game plan sort of unfold for Brown Pinas.
Three rounds of action. Winner of the round gets 10 points. Less dominant athlete gets 9 points. How do you score at a glittering sight inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium? As I glance around, we're about 75% capacity. We will be sold out, and I think it'll only take about half an hour. This place will be full as a ghoul. Will it go to Liam Nolan? Will it go to Brown? Let's go to Tom Lau and find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Liam Nolan.
Liam Nolan takes a decision here in Singapore. The winner's medal goes back to the UK around the neck of young Liam Nolan.